why the will, the immune system, does prevent from disease. It sounds incredible, doesn't it? It is, and it's magic, and it's happening. And this breathing exercise has proven to be able to go very deep into the nervous system. And what they do is reduct CO2 consciously, and O2, therefore, is enriched in the mitochondria. You can influence on the mitochondrial level, which, if you do that with oxygen, it brings about much more energy in the mitochondria. So much more energy is released in the body and in deeper levels, where it normally never comes to, because we live in a shallow physiology. And what we do is break through the conditioned patterns, and we do it like this. It looks very simple. They are in a relaxed modus, using the O2, enriched O2, to go deeper, and it naturally goes deeper. So they do rounds, like 30 breaths, deep inhale, then let go, deep inhale, they become light and loose. That means CO2 goes down, O2 goes up in the mitochondria. So energy is released, goes to the tissues where it never has gone before. And they learn how to pressurize and to manipulate pneumatically these all the parts of the body, because they feel it. That's the way to get to all the body, by the will and respiration, breath. If they come together, then you can control the body. That's one limb of my training. The other one is the cold. We use the cold to test the body and to uptone the cardiovascular system. Every vein in us has muscles. And if you train them, they close, open, well, become strong. And then they help the flow through the body every second of our, and every day, 24 hours, every second, they help the blood flow go through. So the heart doesn't need to pump so much anymore. And after the training, and they do it a little bit regularly, their heartbeat goes down like 20 to 30 beats a minute. That means, and the sufficiency of the blood flow is gotten better. Only because of that already, it's great to embrace cold as your warm friend. Warm is the heart and the blood flow.
Life is a challenge, and I took it that way. I took the cold, and the cold showed me that there is much more power inside.
So, you're known as an Iceman. Why is that?
I'm known as the Iceman because people began to have their name on the internet at a certain time. I'm challenging myself all the time, in the cold as well as the heat, but mostly in the cold, like running marathons and climbing mountains barefoot and swimming under the ice, big distances, records. I got 20 world records therefore. So the name Iceman is coming from that.
What made you decide to tackle cold and extreme temperatures?
Yeah, the cold is really very able to get you, if you go into it gradually, to go deeper into your physiology ever thought possible. It brings you back to the survival modus, to the primordial instincts, and you learn to control. And therefore, the cold really attracted me, instead of yoga, kung fu, karate, esoteric disciplines. They could not bring me there. So the cold did. And I did not have to travel for it because it was just in the park where I lived.
And was there a
I remember it was a Sunday morning. I was pondering once again, as a soul searcher, about what is it about life I'm missing. And then I felt this attraction toward the water where I'm, there was a thin layer of ice, and I looked around, took my clothes off, just went inside, and I felt this is it. Beyond thought, I felt this was it. And from there, because it felt so great, and the reactions, they were really deep and nice and good, I fought it. So the other day I came back and then went back into the water, and surprisingly I could do the same, I felt the same. So I began to go for a long time, and my respiration adapted towards it. It began to be different, more effective, more stronger, because cold is also a force, it has an impact, and for that you need an impact, a force developing from the inside. So at a certain moment it meets, and you can train to have longer time, and all the control is there, and that's all natural. So this natural inner power meeting the cold, that was a great process to encounter.
So you say you're training your body, your mind. What are the techniques that you use? Because a lot of people, you know, they stay up for couple of hours, they suffer hypothermia, and there's all kinds of risks to your body. How do you overcome them?
Simply, the veins around the inner core, if they close up well, then you remain in function. I mean, the liver, the heart, the lungs, brain, they need 37 degrees Celsius blood temperature. But as we do not train the veins anymore, they open up too much, and so the surface temperature, when these people are untrained people, get outside and are too long inside, it mixes with the core blood temperature, and that you create very rapidly hypothermia. Just 2 degrees, and 4 or 5 degrees, it's irreversible, just spirally goes to death. So it's very dangerous cold in that sense, with a bad vascular condition, not trained vascular condition. Now, I'm here with these people, and in 2 days I learned them about this vascular condition to uptone it very quickly, because it's already there, but it's never triggered, it's never stimulated. And you get it really fast back. And now you get the point, the vascular condition, if it is trained well, it reaches the finest threads of the vascular system, which is directly in contact with the white blood cells. So it is feeding the white blood cells a lot better, and the white blood cells is the immune system. So when the white cells are fed better, they are more alert. They are like the guardians, intruders, bacteria, virus, where? But if they are not well fed, then they come in and they go that way, they do their thing, and we become sick. Many diseases. So we need to get back to this vascular condition of ours, our inner power, I call it. Nothing abstract, just physiology, and bring this immune system under our will. Because the will is neurotransmitter. It's all chemistry, it works together, hormones, here are ignited because of hypothalamus and our mind. But we have not our mind not under control. So that's what we learn here too. To disconnect from the hypothalamus is bringing tranquility, deep tranquility in the body. And if you get that, then you learn how to disconnect from the orthosympathetic nervous system, which is the action. But it keeps on running, run, we cannot disconnect. Thus, we cannot get into tranquility, which is the parasympathetic nervous. And if we do that, and that's what we do here, then you get rid of stress hormones. And stress hormones and lactic acid is the ground fundamental, lots of diseases. So we just get rid of it. And that's the way we do it. That's meditation, to go naturally into deep tranquility, parasympathetic nervous system, and take away the stress hormone. And when you need stress, then we can really control the stress hormones, cortisol, which in the case of rheumatism, MS, psoriasis, diabetes 1, is the cause of their disease. Because they get overreactive immune response. The immune system thinks something is happening inside and we need to fight, but nothing is happening. It attacks its own tissue. That are those diseases. And those people cannot suppress the immune response. Thus, they have rheuma, MS, they suffer. That's not necessary, because we have found techniques to be able to tackle them. So, when the immune system is alert again, then it works much more effectively. And where a disease begins, it sees it and pump, suppresses it. Very effective.
So what kind of techniques, breathing techniques or meditation, what are you doing with this group?
This group, I bring them to deep relaxation, or they do it themselves. Just give them a couple of eye openers, and hints, and a little bit of a conviction. Hey man, this is the way it works. Science is backing me up, and it's physiology. And there's no hocus pocus, no sectarian beliefs or whatsoever behind. It is just what it is, so make it work. And if it doesn't work, hey man, you got some resistance going, or some blockage, or you think too much. You're a little bit confused then. What we do is very simple. We bring about the best and cleansing in the autosympathetic nervous system, the action and the peace bring, the parasympathetic. So if we know how to disconnect one of the other, then we know how to connect fully. And that's all about it.
So the first half of the class, they're meditating, they're doing different things, and then you take them outside.
Outside, and we are going to stand like, at that moment, they need to program themselves. Hey, buddy, I'm in connection, right connection now with you, because we opened up with breathing exercises. Full power, potential is there. Now, the will, neurotransmitters, are able to reach the hormones in the body. And what do you need in the cold? You need dopamine and adrenaline. So they program themselves. They give the messages, hey, order, go get adrenaline going in the blood flow and dopamine. And then I say, okay, and now we have. If you have done well with the breathing and everything, then chew well, because it's natural. You gotta learn too. It's a natural method, it's good for you and your children. If you love your children, don't give them pills, give them a natural method. Oh, slow! Like 4 weeks ago, I had a Guinness World Record going with 400 people from 7 years to 77. All the rings, you know? Men, women, children, girls, boys. And they loved it to walk 1 kilometer barefoot on ice. That's what we did. And everybody thought, oh, it's gonna be cold, it's cold, it's cold, it's cold, my feet, oh. After 400 meters, everybody got warm feet. But we never go to this physiological changes in our body, because we think the cold is bad. Oh, it's a hostile world. It's a mind thing. The mindset is totally, it's not okay to work cold. It thinks cold is a hostile, negative thing. But it is not. It ignites the natural mechanisms which we have. And you know what happens? Only because of the 400 meters, then the warm feet you came, is when all kinds of hormones come into the body, and they do not come normally, because we always wear shoes. But these hormones are very good for the heart. It's an absolute direct natural medicine. And it needs it. And that's why we have such problems with the heart and the vascular-related diseases. Nobody knows anymore. It's so simple. So, we have to go back and let Monsieur, you're blessed with a nice, good winter. Take it on as your free fitness room and go into it, because nature's beautiful. And if you feel the feeling, you know, the power is inside, ignited because of the cold, in the right way, do not force, just gradually, then this inner power is beautiful. It's you. Siempre